Hello and welcome, my friend. And next, I am planning to show you that how to disconnect and also connect all of these Toyota VVT-i engines, these fuel injection coolant hoses and air hoses, what are in that location. Because sometimes it could be happens that when we reconnect these hoses and after that we have engine issues. Like engine is difficult to start, and that's, my friend, if you have any issues your car after the car service or car repairs, please check all of these hoses which are connected to this fuel injection line and also in this radiator system. And next I will take all of those hoses away, and I also mark those symbols that how many hoses we have. And let's continue, and I start with that hose in here. Okay, and I start this my job with this hose what comes from this this engine camshaft valve cover, and this is like air hose what moves this bad oil gases to back in this intake manifold and throttle body, and this purpose is to move air, and this is like bad air hose, and for that remove I need pliers, and then I need, and now I use this excellent marker what you can purchase from internet like amazon.com, this solid marker what marks all surface, and now my color is yellow. There's also another part, and now I do first sign, and this means that number one hose is that, and this clamps opens firstly in here in that way, and then I only little bit move and pull out, and this part opens, and then in here that area we can look closer, and now we can see closer, and there is same idea. I install my pliers in here and then compression, and I move that out, and then a little bit rotation, and now this hose is free. Okay, and now this first hose is free, and this hose looks like that, and this hose moves air, bad oily air, to this throttle body and intake manifold. And let's go to take next hose away. Okay, and my next hose is this radiator main hose, and this hose really moves coolant to radiator to engine. And now I measure in here two lines, and this is like second hose what I need to open, and there is purpose that I need again pliers, and there are clamps what I move in this way, and then they are easy to open. This is excellent Toyota's engineering. And let's go to look closer how I open those. Okay, and really I need pliers, and there is this clamp what is connected to radiator, and now I have already removed radiator, but idea is to press this my pliers in that way, and then this metallic clamp opens. And this is really nice engineering, excellent to use, but we need only high quality pliers, and be carefully because there is compression, and if this compression hits to your finger it is hurtly, it hurts our finger, and that's be always carefully and use good quality pliers, and then this part is easy to open. And then there is similar hose in that area, and sorry, this clamp, and I remove that clamp also. Okay, and I remove that next clamp, and in here I compress that, and then I remove that clamp a little bit away, and then a little bit rotation in here, and if this is stuck I can use this my bigger pliers, and now I need to take my bigger pliers. Okay, and now I have bigger pliers, and I adjust the sides, and sides is about that, and then I a little bit rotate that in here, and very near carefully, because otherwise I can damage that hose. And now this hose is easy to remove, and it is there. Okay, and this hose is really radiator coolant hose, and this hose moves water and coolant. This is actually coolant liquid. It is anti-corrosion liquid inside in here, and this purpose is to move and transport this liquid. And let's go to take next hose away. Okay, and my next hose is in that small hose what moves now air, and this valve, so valve and hose in here, it sends air movement to that sensor in here, and also this coal canister what is in here. This is like emission control part, this one, and this is like air hose. And next I mark it firstly, and I take my pencil, and there are 1, 2, 3 lines, and this hose is easy to open because there is this small parts in here, and let's go to look closer. Okay, and there is this clamp, and it is in here, this one, and I can even use my fingers, and then small rotation, and this part opens, and then in here we have another part. And we have another part in here, and I need to use my pliers, and when I little bit compress that part in here, in that way, and then I move this plier away, and carefully I can take this hose away. Okay, and this hose really, it goes in this fuel, it is intake manifold, it is like air hose, and now I take it away in here, that hose, and we can see that part in here. And this third hose is like air hose, and this clamp opens in here in this intake manifold area, so that I press this part in here, and then I move that. This is like smaller size, this metallic clamp, in that way. And this moves, this hose really moves air, and this is like this intake air, because this intake manifold moves air to engine, and this part like moves air in here. And purpose is like sensor technology, and this is like air hose. And let's go to take next hose. Okay, and then I have now removed these electric cables in here, and my next this hose what I remove is this fourth line in here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this hose goes again in this engine valve and camshaft cover to this intake manifold, and just after this throttle body in here. And this is like third point, and this is very easy to open in this up one, in that area. Let's go to look. And this is like up area, and this is easy to open even with fingers, but now I use my pliers in here, and I move that little bit, and in same time I can pull that out in this way. And then we can look closer. Then this hose goes in this throttle body, and there is similar clamp, and I open also that. Okay, and there is this hose, and now I use my pliers again, and I compress this hose, and then then I move this hose in this way and a little bit far away, and then I move that a little bit, and then I remove that hose, and this is like this fourth hose. Okay, and this is really fourth hose, and this purpose is to move air, and actually this camshaft air to this intake manifold. And this is like bad air, what is oily, it goes to intake manifold and then back to engine, and then it burns out. And this is only for emission control, this hose. And let's go to take fifth hose. Okay, and then my fifth hose is now this, now it is coolant hose, and it goes in that area to directly this throttle body. And this is like now liquid hose, and let's go to look closer. And there is this my hose, and this is like number 5. And I do 5 lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is like fifth line. And now there is a little bit harder clamp in here, but in these pliers I can move this metallic clamp away in that way. In here, and then movement. Now when it's open, okay, I move this clamp in back, and now it opens. And then there is in this throttle body area, there is similar clamp. And in that throttle body area, and now in this low area, in their down area, in here, there is this clamp connectors in here. And I need to now use my pliers again. And this is difficult to open, but let's see that how I manage to open that, because this is very bad position. Now it's easy to see in this way. Now we can look closer. Okay, now we can see this position, and this is really, we need good pliers. And now I move that, and then I need a little bit rotate this hose, and then move it away in this way. And this is really coolant hose, and let's look bigger picture. Okay, and this hose is really, normally its position, it's like, it is like in, now this is, it is in that position, and then now I manage to take it out, and this is this hose number 5, and now we can see these clamps, they are much durable in here, and this hose moves coolant. This is like liquid hose. We can see that there's a little bit dropping something in here, and it is coolant liquid. And this is really hose, what purpose is to heat up this throttle body. This is this purpose. And let's go to next hose. Okay, and then my sixth hose is in here, and this is also coolant hose. This is in this cable in here, and I mark in here now 6 lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and let's go to take it out, and I need again pliers, and I start this my job in here, and this is like coolant, and I move that in here, and then this hose is free in here. And then the second line in here, it is in just in this up one, and I compress also this clamp, and then I move this away. And this is like sixth hose. Okay, and this is really sixth hose, and this purpose is to again move coolant. This is like coolant hose, and liquid is inside. And let's go to take next hose. OK, Okay, and my next seventh post is what goes in this throttle bodies, this down area to engine, and it is also coolant hose. And I take my pliers, and there is this hose connector. It is in here, and I compress this part, and then I can move this hose in away, and let's go to look closer. And there we can see this my hose, and now I need a little bit bigger hoses, and I can move that first in here and then pull out. And now this hose is free, and then I can take that another part. And then this another part goes in this side area of this throttle body, when throttle body is in here, and in this area, and it is down area and difficult to open, but now it is easy to see that it is in down area. Okay, again pliers, and this was, by the way, this number 8 is this position, and I mark firstly in here 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now there is 8 lines, and this is hose number 8, and in that area I can open, and then when I move that little bit, it opens nicely. Excellent. And then we can look that. Okay, and this is really hose number 7, and this purpose is to also move coolant liquid, and it is like liquid hose, and purpose is to heat up throttle body, that it is warm. And this is like 8 cable. Okay, and then we have 9 hose, and it is this hose, and this hose is now cabin heater hose in that one, and now I firstly mark in here 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 lines, and then I take it away, and again I need pliers, and there is metallic clamp, and when I little bit move that, in that way I can move it away in here, and if this is difficult, I can use bigger pliers. And now we can see closer, and now I use little bit bigger pliers, and then this clamp opening is easy, and then I rotate a little bit my hose, and then this part, this is coolant liquid hose, and this goes to this cabin heater. Okay, and cabin heater, it is in here, and then I little bit move that, you can see that there is one metallic clamp. Now I open that using my screwdriver. It is Phillips head screwdriver, and then little bit movement, and then if it is stuck, I use my bigger pliers, and then little bit movement in that way, and then hose is free, and this is really coolant hose, as we can see. And this is really 9th hose. There is 9 markings in here, and this is coolant hose. We can see that there is coming coolant out, and this really moves hot coolant to cabin heater, and this cabin radiator what sends hot to cabin area. And let's go to take next hose. Okay, and then we have 10th hose, and this hose goes to this engine, actually this is like air hose in here, and it goes to this brake room, and this big brake, this brake pedal room, what is in here, and let's go to take that out. And now I start this my job in here, and there is this clamp, and I move clamp in here, and then a little bit away, and now this hose is free, and this is like air hose. And in here we can see in that area that there, this is like number 10 line, and it is in now position, and then I a little bit move that hose in that way, and then I can pull out. And this is like number 10, 10th hose, and this hose moves air. This is like air hose, this one. Okay, and then we have hose number 11, and its location is in here. And this hose is connected to engine and then coolant, this cabin heater. And its location is in just in here, and then I mark in 11. And now they are like numbers, 11. And this hose is easy to open with pliers, and let's go to do that. And there is this connector, and when I install this my pliers in here, in that way I can really move this hose, and now maybe this my bigger pliers are easier that way, and then I move this hose a little bit in this movement, and now this hose is easy to remove in that way. Cool. And then next part. Okay, and this hose connector is in here, and I take first this up one. This is like cabin heater hose. Little bit movement, because this is like little bit stuck. Okay, let's see that can I take it? Not yet, because this is stuck, and I need a little bit move that. And this is, I have to work that little bit, but soon it is open. Okay, and now this final hose is also free, and I only a little bit rotate, and then we can look that closer. Okay, and this is really final 11th hose, and this purpose is to move coolant liquid, and this is this information, my friend, and thank you for watching.